There are over 6 million people with heart failure in the United States. It's the leading reason to be hospitalized for adults in the United States, other than delivering a baby. For the Medicare population, for people over 65, it's the main reason to be hospitalized. We know that there are some patients with very advanced heart failure who need a heart transplant or permanent therapy with a left ventricular assist device. The question is what to do with patients who have advanced heart failure, who are certainly limited, but not quite as limited, and with a prognosis not quite as bad as patients who we now transplant or put on a permanent heart pump. The REVIVE-IT trial will test the theory that patients with less advanced heart failure will benefit both in terms of quality and quantity of life with earlier implantation of a left ventricular assist device rather than continued medical therapy alone.
In the past, this therapy has been reserved for the sickest patients with heart failure, and operating on those patients has been associated with complications. The study is designed to determine whether operating in the course of heart failure before patients become very sick would allow patients to recover quicker, experience less complications, and enjoy more of the benefits of ventricular assist device therapy.
Our hope is that by entering into this process earlier, we may be able to really make substantial improvements in people's quality and length of life.
The REVIVE-IT trial is a landmark trial and is a great opportunity to change the field of mechanical circulatory support. The REVIVE-IT trial is a partnership between ourselves, the National Institutes of Health, Thoratec Corporation, the University of Pittsburgh, and 16 other clinical sites.
We're looking for patients who have advanced heart failure as characterized by New York Heart Association Class 3 symptoms. They might be symptomatic walking a block, for example, or maybe going up a flight of stairs. They'll have reduced heart function with a left ventricular ejection fraction of 35% or less, and their heart failure will be chronic and well established for at least a year. Heart transplantation is an enormous success for cardiovascular medicine in the last 30 years. The problem is, in the United States, there's about 2,200 hearts available each year to transplant. We have over 6 million people with heart failure in the United States. Transplantation affects a very, very tiny number of them. We can't make human hearts, not yet anyway, but we can make pumps, and we can make as many as we need. We just have to learn how best to use them, and this study is going to hopefully go a long way to helping us figure that out.